Good morning again. Welcome back to the Soren and the City show on World FM. Our third and last guest of the day is Ashley Kumar, the founder of and artistic director of SAM, which is the South Asian Arts Movement here in Edmonton. She's also pregnant, so congratulations and thanks for coming to the show.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Ashley, what is SAM and what do you guys do?
Well, the South Asian Arts Movement Society is a community-based nonprofit organization that I founded in 2007, although at that time it was called the Shadada Entertainment Group. As far as we're aware, and based on the information available to us, we're the only organization in Alberta providing five styles of South Asian dance under one umbrella. So we offer Kathak, Bharatanatyam, Bhangra, Bollywood, and Indo-Hip-Hop Fusion.
How many people do you have registered? Or like over the years or right now? Or
over the years, we've served over 300 students, which may sound small, but we're a niche market, right? We're a smaller company and we're a niche operation because our styles of dance are not mainstream. And consistently throughout the year, we have about 50 students registered at any time.
Do you have students that are not of South Asian origin?
Absolutely.
What's the percentage?
The percentage is small, I would say between 5 and 10% throughout the years, but that's our goal, our vision, and our mission is to promote and increase the awareness of the variety of South Asian arts across Canada. So we're very lucky. We have people working with us who are not of South Asian origin. For example, my guru, my teacher, she calls herself a Canadian white girl from Whitby, Ontario, but she's the only Canadian-born artist with a master's degree in Kathak from India. And if you see her dance, she has given her heart, blood, soul, tears to the art form from India. So it doesn't matter your race, your culture, your background. It matters what your passion is and how much love you have for dance.
So why did you start this?
Well, to be honest, I've been dancing since I was 10 years old. I started teaching in 2000, and then an opportunity just came up in 2007 to start teaching in the community, and I was like, okay, sure, why not? So I didn't really put much thought into it at that time. But my reason for why I'm doing has evolved over the years from just dancing and just doing shows and productions to helping people. You know, I've experienced a lot of powerful things in my life from, you know, distorted self-image, eating disorders, depression, traumas, and other traumas. And dance and music and arts can actually be very, very healing, not just for yourself, but just sharing with other people can be very, very healing. So I believe I'm in a place now where I can help others. And I want to be a strong role model, especially for girls. So that's how my why has evolved over the years. I call myself a tough love kind of woman. Tough love has made me stronger and more resilient. And I want to teach people, especially girls, to embrace their own power and potential and become immovably resilient and strong.
That is so great, Ashley. Good for you. And now keeping it on the same kind of level, I know that today you are involved with the big event. Tell us about it.
We have our annual dance showcase happening today, this afternoon, at the Stanley Milner Library Theater. Starts at 2 o'clock. And what we did is we opened up about 47 tickets. That was only the amount we could open up for Fort Mac fire evacuees. For the people who've gone through the evacuation and the fire, that is traumatic. When you watch some of the videos of what people have gone through, it's very, very traumatic. And when you don't know what the future holds, it's stressful. So what we wanted to do through our own little way is give back. And so we're offering free tickets for children and adults. And they can just email me. The email is our website at gmail.com. So it's www.saamovement.com@gmail.com. So if they just email me with their Fort Mac ID, we can give them a certain number of tickets, however many they need for our show today.
That's so great. How many people do you expect today?
We would love to have a full house today. And if we, again, I've opened up that block of tickets for some Fort Mac evacuees to attend. And I would love for them to just come and fill up our theater and enjoy an afternoon of arts and culture.
That's great. What else is up for you in the next future, besides obviously bringing a baby in this world? What's up for the summer?
Well, the baby's already dancing inside me, so that's good. We have a little dancer on the way. But this summer, we're actually, right now our programming focuses mostly on dance. But we've always had long-term plans to expand into music, vocal, and drama. So this summer, we're doing our fun little experimental project, and we're calling it The Wizard of Oz Goes to Bollywood. So we're inviting our summer dance students to come and learn acting and dancing this summer. And we're going to do a fun little project production in August. And it's going to be presented in what we call Hinglish these days. Hinglish. Yeah, Hinglish is, it's so common. Even in when you watch Indian films, it's 50% English now. It's such a wide-reaching language. So a lot of the students we have at our school don't speak their native tongue, so their Hindi language. So we want to kind of expose them to both sides of where they live, in Canada to speak English and back home. So it's going to be fun.
Awesome. Good luck with everything, Ashley. Thank you so much for coming here today. And this is it for today, folks. You've been listening to Ashley Kumar, the founder and artistic director of SAM, South Asian Arts Movement. Stay with us. Come back next week. We'll have a few special guests, especially two fresh refugees from Syria. So catch Sorin in the city next week at the same time on the same radio station, World FM 101.7.
Thanks for listening to Sorin in the City.